And welcome back as we are getting ready now for this next game here between Tortle Master and David the Dude. So David the Dude is going to be running a Demon Hunter setup, and Tortle Master will be running Shaman. And so now to get things going, we'll see that both have already kind of laid and are getting started with this match. Couple minions out on the board already for David the Dude. And Tortle Master, of course, having that Shaman. We saw a Shaman in the previous one. He has the ability to put out or summon a random totem on the other side. With Demon Hunter, you get one plus one attack on your turn. I'll also get David the Dude's hand to be shown to us, so we have an opportunity to kind of see what he's got back there. It's a little hard sometimes because it will be upside down to us, but we at least get the options of seeing what he has in his hand and possibilities that he has going forward into the later parts of this match. So we'll see now. Nice big lay there as he's going to be choosing between Stir the Stones and Tame the Flame. So he's got different missions he has to do to proceed further on his shaman journey. David the Dude is from Winnebago. His regular season, he was 4-5, and Tortle Master is from Louisville. Had a 3-2 season. So both of these guys are actually 7th and 8th seeds, so they had to pull some upsets and able to get into this match here to have an opportunity for the state championship. In fact, the only person out of... So usually the top four teams are invited, you know, or the final four for each division are able to come here to state. And the only person to make it out of the top four from regular season was Wild Wolf from Amherst. So impressive run from these two individuals going forward from Winnebago and Louisville. So they are battling it out, and I think it's going to be a very interesting match, both of them having the opportunity to fight for first. We'll see here that Tortle Master is getting very close to hitting Demon Hunter down and just able to attack him directly, as Demon Hunter just wasn't able to get any sort of defense. So that's actually going to be the first match going over to Tortle Master as we wait for the next game to get started. The action kind of just blew by, and really ultimately what came down to the end was the fact that Tortle Master was able to continuously put damage down on to David the Dude, and David the Dude wasn't able to get any taunts out there to soak it up. It was more of an offensive build. So we got Sage now versus Demon Hunter. Tortle Master up 1-0 on David the Dude. We'll see what happens here. He's going to replace a couple cards in his deck. We'll see what his starting deck looks like. Couple high levels, and as well as a level 2 card in there as well. So we'll see how things get started here. He's going to go ahead and just end his first turn. He needs a second mana to be able to work on something here. Looks like David the Dude is going to go ahead and try and throw some attacks in the direction of Tortle Master. That plus 2 and increased damage onto that minion. So actually 4 damage here in the first round. Not feeling too bad for David the Dude. There was a couple changes in the postseason for how a few of these different how some of the mage setups worked. And we'll see the Celestial Ink set getting fired off there. Bunch of 1/1 minions grabbed here as, my goodness, David the Dude He's going to lay down the damage onto Turtlemaster. He'll use up his weapon there, but 5 damage early onto Turtlemaster. It's not a bad thing if you are David the Dude. After spending 5 mana on spells, you reduce the cost of spells in your hand by 5. Loses 1 durability. So working right now on trying to build that up is Turtlemaster. He's just taking some early damage, but there is a purpose behind the early damage he's taking. He's doing what he can to try and defend. Or try to build up for later attacks, I should say. He's taking a lot of damage to get things started. Thinking about using this frost spell, and it'll freeze the frontline minions from Turtlemaster. I'm not allowing them to move here for this turn. I see Battle Rush come on. Demon Claw being used. Just get an additional attack off as Turtlemaster now gets down to 20 health. Gonna throw Deep Freeze out. Freezes an enemy and summons 2 3-6 water elementals. So he'll freeze the guy on the right. Obviously a pretty decent choice, just due to the amount of damage that minion can put out. So he has to force David the Dude now to think about where he's going to attack. He's going to use a weapon, give himself a little bit more damage. It's going to be a +8 damage that's going to go down on the Turtlemaster here. That's a big, big hit for David the Dude, and he's even going to throw another attack onto Turtlemaster. Now Turtlemaster finding himself in a sticky situation. There's a lot of damage that David the Dude has put down just consistently throughout the match, and then that draw there was an amazing draw. Gave him a lot of damage just from his own person to attack, and no taunt members from Turtlemaster. So now here we'll see that Turtlemaster is able to take out a few of the taunt characters from David the Dude, but isn't really able to get anything out there himself that will be able to taunt efficiently. A lot of minions coming down now out of the blue for David the Dude. And man, just damage after damage being put down on Turtlemaster. He's going to have to pull out a very big play here, and I'm not quite sure if there's anything in his pocket that he has to do it. Sure, he's going to be able to put out a lot of different monsters, but he has to get through the taunt members of David the Dude. And we'll see just what happens here. Able to do a couple different attacks, but now we're going to have David the Dude throwing out some more minions of his own. He's going to have +4 damage on his next attack, and with no taunt minions, that's going to go directly on Turtlemaster, and we will be going to a game 3 between David the Dude and Turtlemaster. So, as we prepare for the next game, the first match went very quickly in favor of Turtlemaster, but David the Dude was able to just consistently put through damage that entire previous match. So, we go to our third match. He will have to retire that deck. But hey, this is anyone's game coming here into our third and final match between these two. So, we'll have Turtlemaster bringing out his Paladin setup. And David the Dude will be using a Druid deck. This is honestly, it's very, very close. Either side is able to go back and forth, and just find the options that he has. What it came down to before is that David the Dude just didn't have anything in his pocket anything in his hand to really stop Turtlemaster in that first one, but then Turtlemaster couldn't get any sort of defensive shield in front of him. And it just allowed David the Dude to constantly put down damage almost every single round. And after chipping away at 4 and 5 health, each round started to add up. So we'll see that a couple minions are going to get taken out here immediately from David the Dude. Portal Master throws out a couple, including a taunt member himself. Taunt and Divine Shield. So ignores that damage. It will send it back, but the shield over on the side, David the Dude, will keep his druid quite safe. So able to take that minion off the board, though it looks like he will take at least a little bit of damage. Plus one to all minions in his hand, so this Overlord is going to assist the hand of Tortle Master quite a bit. And once again, pretty good moves by David the Dude, constantly shielding up his main character and then able to attack a minion directly on the field. Plus one for Tortle Master. So we'll see now what comes up on this next one. Blade of the Wyvern taken out with that poison especially. With that summoning, it's going to bring up another minion to assist. This attack here is going to be very important as it just once again boosts up Tortle's deck. I hovered over it before to show you, but whenever he attacks, every card he has in his hand gets a plus one power up, and he's used it twice, so they are now all plus two in attack and defense. So the next cards that he pulls out will be pretty strong, much stronger than what they should be usually. And unless David the Dude is able to take it out, which it looks like he's going to go straight for it here, as it does have the Divine perk as well, he is able to hit it. All right, and then we've got, once again, some beefed up units down here that are going to come in and help a little bit. Divine Shields on most of the cards that he's playing. Nice damage coming through, and he's actually also able to hit at David the Dude. A little bit of damage to get things going. So Tortle Master starting to get a little bit of this game in his possession. But a nice move by David the Dude. He's going to have a pretty decent front line. It'll be fairly weak, though. It's a front line that's going to be somewhat weak to Tortle Master's first attacks here, especially with these units that do have the Divine Shield. Able to hit with some pretty big damage across the board. Plus seven being hit onto David the Dude's health bars directly, and his bigger minions taken off the board. And there is a lot of health and a lot of damage on Tortle Master's setup. He's going to boost up some of his own minions and choose a few more cards here. A nice big frontline tank. He's going to try to take out one of the hard hitters from Tortle Master. Now, this is a pretty decent tank on the front line, however, with this card right here, able to give a little bit of health to everybody on this line. So now, big hits coming through, and David the Dude is going to get hit for some pretty decent damage. Not to mention, all of his cards are taken off the table, and he will end up playing Deathwing the Destroyer. It's going to destroy all the cards in his hand, as well as take out all the cards on the deck or on the playing field itself. So a little bit of a reset, not to mention some pretty big damage coming through. But this is going to be a nice hit from Tortlemaster as he uses True Silver Champion. Not only does he get damage off, but he will restore damage to himself. But he is going to take a pretty big hit here. First the attack from David the Dude directly, then another one from his Deathwing. So big plus 12 damage coming through, but we'll see what happens here as Tortlemaster has to, of course, attack the taunt minions first. He's going to attack this one directly. I mean, those taunt minions have plus 7 health, so they've got a lot of health to them. This actually could be David the Dude taking... Oh, no, he won't be able to win. Sorry. I was about to say something that isn't correct. He's going to do a lot of damage to this taunt hero, but it's also one that had a divine shield. So he does the damage and is able to get the hit, but most importantly is he's not able to attack with his Deathwing onto Tortlemaster directly. That would have been plus 12 damage straight onto Tortlemaster, which would have ultimately brought him down to just 2 health left. David the Dude is trying to decide now if he's going to attack directly or hit one of these smaller minions and take them off the court. So now 5 Silverhand recruits coming in. And though they are small, they are able to do at least enough poke damage immediately. And actually, that will be it. David the Dude now able to finish... Tortlemaster able to finish off David the Dude and claim the victory for himself here. So, we have David the Dude getting the win and wonderfully, wonderfully done. A really good job even at the very end. So, we will be right back with our next game, which is going to be against Battlecat09 and Harry Jerry. We'll be right back.